In this tutorial, I'm going to talk about the box model and how we can apply margins, paddings, and borders to a HTML element. And we'll take a look at how those margins, paddings, and borders affect the element themselves. So what you're seeing on the screen here is an example of a HTML element. It could be an image, a heading, a paragraph, a div, a section, a whole manner of things. And we're going to give our element a width and a height, and we'll define that with CSS. So in our CSS file, we might be seeing something like this. There's the class name for our element, or it could be the selector for the element itself. And we've given it a height of 100 pixels and a width of 200 pixels. And what we can do is add some padding to that. And the padding in CSS, we might write that as padding 10 pixels, which would add 10 pixels of padding to each side of the element, but you'll see it hasn't actually changed the height or width of the element either. It sits outside the element. We can then go further and add a border to it, and in CSS we might write the border like this, a 1 pixel border, it's solid, and a border color of black, and the border sits outside the padding, which sits outside the element. And then finally, we might add a margin, and the margin might be added to our CSS file, such as this, margin 10 pixels. And once again, that sits outside everything, so it kind of contains the whole thing. It sits outside the border, which sits outside the padding, which sits outside of the element. And you'll see none of the paddings, margins, or borders have changed the width or height of the element at all. That still remains the same. So let's actually apply all of that to some real HTML. So I've got a HTML file here, which contains a heading. I've got a div with some dummy text and an image. And just so I can apply the same styles to each element, I've given each of these elements the class name box model. Now, remember with classes, the name that appears as the class name can really be anything. I've just chosen to call it box model. It really could be any name that I wish. In my CSS file, let's write some classes. So I have an empty CSS file here. I'll add the name box model. And I know it's a class because I've used a full stop, which indicates that it's a class, and some curly brackets as we use in the syntax for CSS. Let's give our element a height and a width. So I might say height 100 pixels, width 300 pixels. And let's save that and take a look at our website so far. So this is our website without any CSS attached, a heading, we have a div with some text and an image. And now that I've created some CSS, let's refresh the page and see what happens. Okay, so our elements have now got fixed heights and widths. It's a little bit hard to see at the moment. So what I might do is actually apply a background color just to demonstrate that these are in fact living inside a box with some fixed dimensions. So let's head back over to our CSS. And I've now applied a light gray background. So we'll just jump back to the website, I'll refresh the page, and you can see here that our heading has a height and a width, and so does our div containing our text and our image as well. So that just makes it a little bit easier to see. Now you'll notice that on our heading, there's some space at the top and the bottom, and that's actually a margin. By default, headings have a top and bottom margin. So let's jump over to our CSS, and the first thing I want to do is apply some padding. So let's say a padding of 30 pixels around every side of the elements. So I'll just jump back over to our website, refresh the page, and right away, there's some padding going on. You can see how everything has just expanded. And it's illustrated quite well with our image because our image dimensions have still remained the same, 100 pixels high, 300 pixels wide, but it now has this additional padding around it, which hasn't changed the dimensions at all. It simply has enveloped the image. Now let's add a border. So we'll say a border of maybe 10 pixels. I want it to be a solid border, and let's make our border black. Save that, jump back over to our website and refresh the page. And as you can see, our border is now enveloping or wrapping around the padding, which is also wrapping around the element itself. And lastly, I'll apply some margin. Now, keep in mind that our heading already has margin, and that is wrapping around everything. So we've got some white space at the top and the bottom here of our heading. So that's a top and bottom margin. So let's just jump over to the CSS. I'll apply a margin to every side of of our elements, and I'll say a margin of 30 pixels. I'll save that, and we'll jump over to the website and refresh the page. So now there's a margin wrapping around every side of the heading, our div, and our image as well. Now, of course, you can't see the margin, it's essentially invisible, but what it has done is it's moved the element across to the left and the top and the right. It's basically an invisible padding, I guess you could think of it as. So I hope that demonstrates the box model a bit more, and thank you for watching.